If you manage even a single WordPress website, you definitely should be using Cloudflare's free DNS system because it significantly helps with security and performance of your website. The free plan is insanely generous and gives you all kinds of powerful features like DDoS protection, free SSL certificates, super fast DNS, and all kinds of other things. But what I'm going to do in this video is walk you through how to make it even more secure and more performant using some custom firewall rules. These rules were created by Troy Glancy, and he shared them in a blog post that he attached in the Admin Bar Facebook community. And what he's done is taken his wealth of Cloudflare experience, distilled it down into a useful guide. And what I'm going to do is walk you through how to implement it. It's not particularly difficult, but there's a ton of information, and I'm going to do my best to distill it down and show you specifically how to do it on your website. So once you have your website activated on Cloudflare, why would you want to go to the trouble of adding all these additional firewall rules? Well, this means that it's going to help prevent malicious attackers and spammers and all kinds of people who you don't want accessing your website from taking up resources, wasting bandwidth, potentially causing security issues if there's plugins or, you know, other problems with vulnerabilities on your website. And what will happen with these rules is either those people are blocked entirely or Cloudflare's system will prevent a challenge to them. And if they don't pass the challenge, they're just banned from the website. Now, typically when I'm referring to they, it's just a bot or some kind of other malicious activity. Every once in a while, it will be a real person, but Cloudflare's system is extremely intelligent and typically will let legitimate users through with no problem at all. Another thing we're going to do here is whenever somebody tries to access our WP login page, it's going to present them a managed challenge. Typically for legitimate users like us, it's only going to take Cloudflare a quick second and it will let you right through. But anything that looks malicious or spammy, it's just going to block and prevent them from accessing your login page. And it's just a good idea in general. So all of what we're going to do is a huge level up in terms of security and performance on your website. So let's go ahead and get started. So I'm going to do this really live, you know, for a real website, which is going to be for pycalendar.com. And what we're going to do is first of all, start off by just, you know, making sure you have your domain activated on Cloudflare. All you got to do is just change the name servers after you add it into your account, and you can just select the free plan. All of this stuff is totally free, which is super awesome. So you can see PyCalendar has been activated on Cloudflare for some time now. And what I want to do is just come down to the security tab, and then I'm going to go to WAF here, or Web Application Firewall, the WAF. And what we want to do is go to this custom rules tab. So what we're going to do is come down, and you can see we have 0 of 5 rules, which is perfect because we're going to be adding 5 rules to this website. Let's just click on create rule. And what we're going to do is quickly switch over to Troy's resource here, where I'm going to grab most of this information from. So you can see kind of by the end of this, this is what our web application firewall page is going to look like. And we're going to go through these one by one. So we're going to come down here and we can just kind of take a look. Now, what we want to do to start off with is we're going to create a rule called allow good bots. And you can see that in this screenshot, it's going to allow a ton of common things that you would want to access your site, like search engine crawlers, you know, security tools, accessibility tools, webhooks, things like that. And this is just a good idea to kind of enhance Cloudflare's existing known good bots rule. So what we can do is just simply minimize this. And you can see that there's this option right here that says allow good bots expression. So what we can do is actually copy this. And then I'll come back over to my application rule here. And we'll just call this good bots or allow good bots, whatever you want to call it. Then all we have to do is instead of building this manually from, you know, like copying the screenshot, we can click on edit expression, paste this in, and then just click that same button again. And you can see it fills in exactly like Troy recommends here, which is amazing. Then what we want to do is scroll down, then choose action. We're going to come down to this option that says skip in this case, and we're just going to tick every single box here. Boom, 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 boom. And before we deploy it, we can just quickly take a look at what's happening here. So we're just saying that if it's in the Cloudflare known bots rule, we're going to let them into our website. And we're just adding a couple of additional ones to kind of enhance this rule here. Then some other common ones like let's encrypt for SSL, that's going to be allowed to come through as well. So then we'll just come down and we're going to click on deploy. In that previous screen, you couldn't see the deploy button. It's right over here, just so you know. And our first rule is done. Easy as that. Now, the magic sauce really starts to show up in these next couple of rules. That one's not that special. These next ones are really where we're going to see some improvements. Okay, so back to our custom rules tab here. What we're going to do is create another one. And when we're on the, you know, back on Troy's blog post here, this modified good bots is if you've used his good bots setup in the past, his older version. So if you haven't, just ignore the section and we can move on down to the next one, which is called aggressive crawlers. So what this is going to do is block all kinds of different tools that are going to be accessing your site repeatedly on a regular basis that you might not even care about. Like Yandex is a search engine that you might not have any interest in, along with Baidu and a bunch of these other things. Tons of these things you probably aren't going to want. So what we can do is just, again, we're going to copy this expression. We'll say the rule name of aggressive crawlers. There we go. And then again, edit expression, pop that in, and it's gonna fill all of that in here. Now, I specifically asked Troy about the like Ahrefs option here, or SEM Rush. If you use those tools, you can actually leave these alone because the other rule that we created has those in that known good bots rule. So this is just kind of doubling up, which is totally okay. So I was tempted here to actually delete Ahrefs out of here because I do actually use that on a lot of my own websites, but our previous rule is going to take precedent because this one is actually going to be deployed second. So we're gonna scroll down here, just all the way down to the bottom. You can see there's a ton of stuff that Troy set up for us. And then this time in the then take action section, we're gonna choose manage challenge. And then right now, because this is only our second rule, this place at select order of last is totally fine. So once again, we're gonna click on deploy. And now we've got two of our five rules on there. So this is awesome. And we should start seeing stuff because this site gets a decent bit of traffic. We should start seeing activity in these reports here in just a little while. Next up, we're gonna move on down to the challenge large providers slash country section. What this rule is going to do is provide a managed challenge to services that are coming from Amazon EC2 or Google Cloud servers, Azure servers, things like that, because hackers and spammers, as you can see here in the description, can easily fire up those VPS servers, mount large scale attacks really quickly, and sometimes they can be factors in DDoS attacks. But as you can see here in Troy's note, a lot of, you know, legitimate services and resources out there are already going to be in the known and verified bots list that Cloudflare directly protects our sites with. However, you can see, like in Troy's note here, he mentions that a lot of legitimate services are already going to be included and protected on our websites from Cloudflare directly. So we don't really have to worry about most legitimate services that might run on those platforms like Amazon and Google from being blocked. This is going to be, you know, typically illegitimate kind of services that are running on this. So if we take a look at the screenshot here, we can see that it's going to block a ton of different AS numbers, which are like their IP address block ranges. Then there's a bunch of other conditional things we can see here. In this case, this expression says if that server country is not originating in the United States, then, you know, it needs to be challenged as well. And then there's also a variant of this rule. If we scroll down here, if you don't want it to be based on the country of origin for that server, you can either, you know, modify it to your own country, or you can just remove it entirely, depending on which one you want. So in this case, I think I'll do the one without the country challenge. So I'll just go ahead and take this expression here. Again, we're going to go to create rule. This one is going to be MC for managed challenge large providers is what I'll call this one. Again, we're going to pop this expression in, and there we go. Looks good. So now we're going to scroll down. Then again, we're going to take action of manage challenge. And what we want to do here is set this order to custom, and then it's going to come after the aggressive crawlers. Go ahead and deploy this. Next up, we're going to go create yet another rule, of course. And what this one is going to do is present a managed challenge to anybody that tries to access our WP login page, or if they're using a VPN. Now, of course, I'm aware there are legitimate uses for VPNs, but they are predominantly used for malicious activities or can be used for them. So in this case, I'm not really worried about that. So I'm just going to block, you know, most all VPN providers. But again, this is presenting a managed challenge, so it's not a guarantee that they'll be blocked. It's just adding an additional layer of security before it lets them access the site. So what we want to do here is, again, just take our expression. We're going to pop this in. We're going to give this one a name of, you know, MC for VPN and path is what I'll call this one. And I'll show you why in just a second. So this is actually two rules in one. We're going to challenge them if they're in a VPN provider's, you know, IP address block, which is all of these, or if they try to reach the path of WP login on our website. Then of course, we're going to again take action, manage challenge, and then place that order of last is fine in this case as well. We'll go ahead and deploy this. Now we've got our fourth rule, and we're gonna add one final one to the end here. Now this one is a little bit confusing because you can see that says this blocks web hosts. Now what's not going to happen here is it's not going to prevent you from loading your website because, you know, let's say maybe your websites are hosted on Vulture or DigitalOcean, and we're blocking those in this rule. But what's actually taking place here is if an IP address is originating from one of those servers and tries to access yours, then it will be blocked. This is another case where somebody could spin up a DigitalOcean server really quickly, do something malicious with it, and maybe that server only lasts a day or, you know, maybe however long, but it can be a huge penalty to your server resources. And so it's just a good idea in general to go ahead and block all of these. But we'll go ahead and whitelist our server's IP in Cloudflare as well to prevent any issues with things like cron jobs and so on. So what we're gonna do is take this expression again, gonna create this rule here, and we're gonna say block hosts and paths. So edit expression, pop that in. And what it's going to do is block a ton of different web hosts so that illegitimate traffic originating from those hosts does not affect our website at all. Then it's going to look at a couple of other really common WordPress attack vectors. XML RPC is one, WP config. There's no reason for somebody to access that URL externally. And then a bunch of other things like, you know, verified bot crawlers of AI. And then if they are on the Tor network, we're going to block those because typically, you know, legitimate businesses are not involved in the Tor network in any way. So we don't need to worry about traffic on that network. So in this case, what we're going to do, scroll down and we're just going to say select action, just block straight up. So then we can go ahead and deploy this rule. And there we go. We have our 5 firewall rules. So now we've done a really broad range of protection and security enhancements. What we want to do at this point is now go into the tools tab. And what we're going to do here is actually stick in our web host server IP just right here. Then we're going to choose the action of allow, and then we're going to say all websites in this account. So if you have multiple like care plan servers like I do, or you have, you know, maybe a dedicated server for your own projects, you'd want to add this a couple of times. You can see down here, I've added a value here for my own server that has my projects on it. And so this is just going to allow all the websites in this account to access this IP, regardless of what server they're on. And that's something that we need to do based on that last rule that we added where we're blocking all of those other web hosts. This is also really important because if you have cron jobs, we want to make sure that that IP address is whitelisted here so those cron jobs run appropriately. And that's basically it. We already covered the whitelisting server IP, which is what we just did. And then there's also the option of disabling onion routing as well, which is kind of related to the Tor network. It's not something I've implemented in this case, but you certainly can. I also wanted to point out you can directly support Troy and his effort here by just a simple donation, or you can sign up for an upcoming Cloudflare course from him, which would be super awesome. So you'll notice here on my screen, I switched over to a different URL, which is just my main website of jonathanjernigan.com. And I set this up just about, you know, maybe 30 minutes before I started this recording. And you can see, look at all the activity that's already being blocked. There's like, what, you know, 200 different things that have already been either challenged or blocked entirely. So like, if we look here, if we're gonna go down to like the block section, we could come down and take a look. Let's just say like, you know, a United States block. Why were they blocked? Let's take a look. They're trying to reach that URL of XML RPC. Like, we don't want that. There's absolutely no reason for that IP address to be accessing that URL on my server. So Cloudflare is just going to stop that at the DNS level before it ever reaches your website. Again, all of these things are designed to increase security and performance of your website. So it's just a good idea to do. It's all totally free. Troy has been generous enough to share this incredible resource with us. Super thankful for that. And so big shout out to him. If you're interested in learning more about this kind of stuff, I featured this in my newsletter this past week. You can visit my website at jonathanjernigan.com. In the footer, there's a little newsletter signup link, and you'll be the first to hear about cool things like this, as well as all kinds of other great resources for WordPress web designers. Hope you've enjoyed this video. It took me a little while to wrap my head around how to implement all of this, so I was hoping that maybe this video would be helpful for you too. Let me know in the comments your thoughts. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.